understand what plains as a landform is. A plain is a broad area of relatively flat land. Plains are one of the major landforms or types of land on Earth. They cover more than one-third of the world's land area. Plains exist on every continent. Plains are the most fertile regions. They are the stretches of large land. These stretches of land are the most suitable for human habitation and agriculture activities like farming and poultry. The plains of India include the Northern Plains and Coastal Plains. In this video, we will be covering the Northern Plains. Just below the Himalayan mountains lies the Northern Plains of India. They stretch from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. Plains are highly populated area. We are also living in a plain land. Most of the people prefer to live in the plain areas because the land here is very fertile. Also, the climatic conditions are also very suitable for all living beings. Now, let's see how these plains are formed. We have studied the Himalayan mountains remain covered with snow throughout the year. During the daytime, sunlight melts the snow and the water flows downwards from the mountain. And thus, many rivers originate from the Himalaya and flow through the Northern Plains. These rivers carry water throughout the year. When these rivers flow downwards from the mountains, they bring broken pieces of the rocks, sand, and silt. Silt is the fine sand, clay, or other material carried by the running water. The fine silt that is deposited by the rivers is called alluvium. Thus, alluvium is a deposit of clay, silt and sand left by the rivers. This is very fertile and is very good for crops. And that is the reason why our country's northern plains are covered with agricultural land. When this water comes down from the mountains, they form rivers. And these rivers, along with their tributaries, form basins. Let us understand these terms one by one. Tributary. A tributary is a small river that flows into a big river. Basin. A basin is the portion of land that is watered by a river and its tributaries. For example, this is the main river and these are its tributaries. So, this is the area which is watered by the main river and its tributaries, and hence this area is known as basin. The Northern Plains are formed by three rivers and their tributaries. These three rivers are Satluj, also known as Satluj, Ganga, and Brahmaputra. Let's start with the Satluj River basin. River Satluj originates in Tibet. Satluj River flows towards the southwest through Punjab and Haryana in India. Bias is the main tributary of Satluj River. The Bhakra Dam is built across River Satluj. A dam is a structure which is made across flowing water that stops the flow of water, often creating a reservoir. The Bhakra Dam generates hydroelectricity. Hydroelectricity is the electricity that is generated from the fast flowing water. The water from Bhakra Dam also provides water for irrigation. Next is the Ganga River Basin. River Ganga originates from the Gangotri Glacier in the Himalayas. The main tributary of Ganga is Yamuna. Ganga is the largest river in India. River Ganga is considered as a sacred river to Hindus. It is worshipped as goddess Ganga in Hinduism. The Ganga and its tributaries flows through Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. In West Bengal, as you can see in the picture, the river splits into two branches, that is Padma and Hooghly. Padma enters Bangladesh and joins Brahmaputra from there. Hooghly flows through West Bengal. Next is the Brahmaputra River Basin. River Brahmaputra originates in Tibet and is called Tsangpo there. It enters India through the northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh, flows through and later on enters Bangladesh. Have you ever heard about Sundarban Delta? It is the largest delta in the whole world. But what is delta? We have just studied when a river flows downwards from a mountain, it carries a great deal of silt, clay and rocks, and this settles down. This occurs when a river enters an ocean, sea or lake. That area of land is called a delta. The word delta comes from the Greek letter which looks like a triangle. Thus, a delta is a triangular shaped land formed by the river before it flows into the sea. So, the Sundarban Delta is formed by Brahmaputra and Ganga before these rivers fall into the Bay of Bengal. It is famous for Sundari trees in Sundarban Island. The Sundarban Delta is famous for its unique mangrove forests. It is the biggest home of Royal Bengal Tigers. Okay students, now let's read about people's life in the Northern Plains. First, let us see what all states lie in the Northern Plains. See the map. Just below Himalayas lie the state of Punjab, Haryana, National Territory of Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal and Assam. These all states lie in the Northern Plains. The main occupation of the people of this region is farming. Can you guess why? Because of the Ganga, Indus and Brahmaputra rivers. These plain regions are rich in alluvium and therefore highly fertile. This helps in a heavy cultivation of crops. As a result, a large number of people live in the Northern Plains. People grow rice, wheat and sugarcane. Let us read about these states one by one. First is Punjab. Punjab is a neighboring state. Agriculture is the main occupation of the state. Punjab contributes a major share of the wheat and rice stock. The farmers of Punjab are less dependent on manual labor and use modern machines such as tractors and harvesters. People of Punjab are fond of makke ki roti, sarso ka saag and lassi. They celebrate Baisakhi and Lohri. The men and women perform folk dances of Bhangra and Gidda celebrating the joyous occasions. Golden Temple in Amritsar is a very famous tourist place in Punjab and many tourists visit here every year. Next state is Haryana. The soils of Haryana are generally deep and fertile. Thus, most of the people in Haryana, just like Punjab, are engaged in agriculture and use modern machines for farming. Many people are also engaged in cattle rearing and dairy farming. The state's largest cities include Faridabad and Gurugram. Gurugram, earlier known as Gurgaon, which have many industries such as information and automobiles. Next is our country's capital, National Capital Territory of Delhi. Delhi is the capital of India. It stands on the bank of River Yamuna. Being the capital of India, Delhi is the center stage of all political activities. Many offices are situated here and many people work in these offices. Each year, Delhi attracts a huge number of tourists from all over the world. Some of the monuments of tourist interest are Red Fort, Qutub Minar, India Gate, Humayun Tomb, Jama Masjid, Lotus Temple, and Akshardham. Culture of Delhi is diverse because people come from different parts of the country. Next state is Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is one of the largest states situated in the north part of India. 70 to 80% of sugarcane production in India comes from Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is famous for guavas and mangoes. Along with this, the state has many sugar textile, leather and chemical industries. The local specialities of Uttar Pradesh are the silk saris of Varanasi, brassware from Muradabad, and chicken curry embroidery from Lucknow, which are famous all over the world. The famous Kumbh Mela is held every 12 years in Allahabad, which is now known as Prayagraj. Apart from this, Agra, Varanasi and Lucknow are some of the cities of tourist interest. Let's move on to the next state, that is Bihar. Bihar is famous for lychees. The famous dishes of Bihar are Litti Chokha and Sattu Paratha. The city of Bhagalpur is a center of silk weaving. The Chhath Puja is the most celebrated festival in Bihar. It is an important festival and is celebrated for 6 days where people worship the sun god. Most of the people in Bihar speak Maithili and Bhojpuri. The famous places of tourist interest are Patna, Gaya and Rajgir. Next, we move on to West Bengal. The crops grown here are rice, jute and tea. The northern areas around Darjeeling have long been known for their production of high quality tea. Jute mills are located on both the banks of Hooghly River. The state is located on the side of Bay of Bengal and thus fishing is an important occupation of the people in the coastal region. Bangla is the most spoken language here and the popular festival is Durga Puja. And the last state is Assam. Tea and jute widely cultivated in Assam. Assam grows a large portion of the country's tea. Women wear mekhela chador and blouse. Assamese is the most spoken language by the people of Assam. Petroleum and natural gas are found in Digboi. Bihu is the famous festival celebrated in the spring to mark the beginning of the new year.